Hello everyone and welcome to our latest Facebook Live interview. Over the past couple of weeks, Ross Barkley and Ashley Williams have sat down alongside us to answer your questions. I'm delighted to say it's Morgan Schneiderlin's turn today. So the incentive to send in your questions today is that you can win this shirt, which Morgan will sign. Morgan's favourite, the winner will get that shirt. So we'll get straight to it. Liam Hughes asks the first question. Is it true that you learnt the English language by watching Only Fools and Horses?
That's not really true, but the thing, I didn't take any English lessons when I arrived in England. You know, I just picked up things because there was no foreign players, there was no people who were speaking French, so I had to speak English very quick. And I picked up by watching TVs, by watching things. And then the thing is that every time you travel on a coach from game to game, the players used to put Only Fools and Horses in a coach, and then I was watching, I was trying to pick up some words, and then at one point he helped me a little bit, but it's not only this reason.
A question from Mick NSNO. Is there any celebration ideas for what you're going to do when you score your first Everton goal?
Hopefully we will see that very, very, very soon, but I don't really have a celebration because that's not something I used to do every weekend, scoring goals, but I will see what's happening in the game. If I score a last minute winner or if I score a 4-5-0, I will see and I will try to surprise you.
Next question from Toffee Paul 1878. You've been here almost 2 months now. Do you now realise how massive of a club Everton is?
Yeah, it's a big club, big expectation. It's a lot of tradition of things that the fans want and everything, and I'm relishing this challenge. You know, obviously I come from Manchester United, where the challenge was big as well. You know, so I'm used to this kind of things, and I like it. And hopefully, we can improve as a squad and everything, and make this club even bigger.
A question that's only just come in a minute or so ago from Joe Nesbitt. Why did you pick the number 2 shirt?
I picked the number 2 shirt because there was not a lot of choices. It was the number 2 or number 33, 34, 36, things like that. And I wanted to take a small number. Obviously, I have some favorite numbers. They were all taken. So I took the number 2 for the moment. I know a lot of people don't see a midfielder as a number 2, but it's just a number, and then we see at the end of the season if I have some good games, if I play well, if the team is doing well. Maybe I will be superstitious and I will not change, but I will see at the end of the season if I keep it or if I change it.
A question on music from Tom. What music do you like to listen to before a game? What is your favourite genre of music?
I like a bit of everything, but I have a play mix on my phone, which is a old school R&B, a little bit like that, with some old school song that I like to put me in the mood of a game. But I like to hear everything. You know, I'm open to a lot of variety: French, English, American, everything. So
a wide variety, quite a wide variety of music. Then
you know, I like to hear everything. A good song is a good song. You know, like I say, so I don't have any particular thing.
And while we're talking about songs and music, what do you think about the song that the Everton fans have adopted for you?
I like it very much.
That's from John, that question.
Yeah, I like it very much. You know, I think I retweeted it on my social network, you know, because I felt very well welcome. I feel very honored by the song they sing straight away, and for me it's something that pushed me even harder, you know, to work even harder and to be, because I really appreciate the appreciation of the fans.
A question from Charlene Blackburn, NSNO. That's only just come in a few seconds ago. What do you think of the atmosphere at Goodison Park now you're an Everton player and played in the royal blue shirt?
Oh, it's been fantastic. My first game against City when we won 4-0, he set quite the standard, you know, with a very, very good, very good tempo. I like the music when we come in on a pitch. I like the atmosphere at the end. I love it. But after, you know, every atmosphere in the stadium comes with performances. If you keep doing well, if you keep winning, I'm sure the fans will keep singing very loud and everything. And hopefully when we're going to dig in, it's going to be a bit harder. They're going to sing even more to give them more energy.
Zach Cairns asks, where would you like to see the club, how would you like to see the club progress in the future?
Oh, I would like to see progress very much. No, that's why I came here, I signed here, because I believe in the project. I have the belief that this club will push forward. Obviously, this year we're going to see where we're going to end up. We're going to try to win as many games as possible, try to finish in Euro. And then next year, the manager will bring some more players to improve the squad, to improve the team and everything. And hopefully, we can push to that top five in a Premier League. And I'm sure the club dreams of a Champions League place. And hopefully, in 3 years' time, maybe we can give that to them.
How confident are you of a top five finish this season?
This season, well, we're not going to add to the fact that it's going to be hard. It's not just going to help to us, because if every teams are winning the games and we are winning, they're still going to be in front of us. So we're going to try to win as many games. We have some big games coming, Liverpool, Manchester United, Arsenal. So hopefully we can pick up some points against them and win against the team who are below us. And then we see, we want to secure a place in European. And hopefully one team gonna have a hard end of the season to finish sixth, fifth. We're going to see, but this team, this football club needs to take time by time and not get carried away too much, you know, because we have some good results, but keep improving every day. And in the future, in the very near future, we can challenge for the top five.
Just rewind now to when you was a young lad growing up in France. Emile Lemens wants to know, who was your idol when you was growing up? Who was your footballing hero?
Like, I'm French and everything, my football hero was Zidane. You know, he was something who was class on the pitch. He was just an amazing player. You know, his technique, his view of the game and everything. He was just amazing, and he gave the World Cup to a French nation, which was amazing.
Do you remember that World Cup?
Yeah, I think every French people who used to live at this time remember where they were at this moment, where they used to watch the game, what they did after this game. I remember that all my city, they came to my we go to a place watching the game, and after we went on the cars, you know, singing and going around the streets, bouncing the horn on the car. It was just amazing.
You joined in January and at the same time, in the same month, Ademola Lookman was signed as well. A question from Daniel Mark: what do you think of Ademola and the impact he's made so far?
No, he's a very good player. You know, you can see in the train. First, I can say that I didn't really know him. I didn't watch any game of him because he was playing at Charlton and everything. But I've heard of him. Some people were telling me that he's a very, very good player. And then in the first training session, you can see straight away, first touch, first thing, that who is a good player and everything. And he's the one who caught your eye, because he has something special, he has talent, but he knows that he needs to improve in certain area of the game, you know, because he's still young and everything. But he's a good listener. He listens to older people. He asks for some advices, and he's a very, very good kid, and I'm sure he will go far.
Quite an interesting question that's just arrived only a second or so ago from Paul Catterall. Who would win in a 50-50 tackle between you and Idrissa Garnagay?
I don't know. I don't know. Maybe him, maybe me, it depends, you know. We don't know, but the good thing is that I'm with him every weekend, and we can win against others.
And leading on from that, Anne Black wants to know, do you think you and Idrissa can become the best holding midfield partnership in the Premier League in time?
That's our aim, you know. After we have for the two games we played together, we felt good against Middlesbrough, against Sunderland. You know, we felt good together. I can see that he wants to get the ball back. He wants to link up the play. You know, and I like that. You know, he's a very good player who has everything, and I'm relishing to play with him. And hopefully we can be a great partnership and be a struggle for every team.
Last couple now, Morgan. Stephen Barston. This question from him: who is the most skillful player you have ever played against?
The most skillful player. I would say Just skillful wise, it was Adel Tarabt. I don't know if you know him or if some people.
At QPR and
QPR, Tottenham. I used to play with him when he was under France, and then he played for Tottenham, QPR, and everything. He was the most skillful. You know, the, you have some great players. You know, like I say, I can say some very good players, but he was, you know, the guy who was used to mix you and everything. The talent he has doesn't reflect the career he had and is having at the moment. So yes, he's the most skillful player I played against and with.
And what is your favourite cheat snack? If there's anything you like to eat that perhaps you're not allowed or on a day off?
Well, do you have time? Because I can tell you for 20 minutes now. Do you know, I always tell to my family, friends and girlfriend and everything that when I stop my career, I will be fat because I like chocolate, I like sweets, I like things like that. And I used to be a bit, when I was 18, you know, because I used to eat those kind of thing. But now I just say to my future wife, don't buy anything, please. Just leave the fridge, nothing. Because when you watch TV, I always need to bite something. So I prefer to eat a fruit. But yeah, chocolate, sweets are my favorite things.
Well, that's great. Thank you for joining us today, Morgan. And thank you for sending in your questions. We'll ask Morgan now off camera to pick his favourite and the winner. We'll get this shirt, which Morgan will sign. So thanks again for joining us.
Thank you.